afternoon to each and everyone in Georgetown, Guyana, friends all. I have a message to release here today to the political circle, may it be APNU, PNC disguising as a unity party, or may it be the PPPC. I first will address the PNC. I want you to remember the 1960s, the late 1960s, under the late Foss Burnham, when Indian women and children was raped and beaten in Mackenzie, and young girls, 3 and 6 years, bottle and stick was pushing their private parts, where H&L Kisun had to use a place at a factory to house them, and in other rural area of Guyana. And for when the Indian retaliate against innocent black people also, I want to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, fellow Guyanese, do not fall for the trap. Whether it be APNU, PNC, or whatever political group to mislead you, because 65 ministers are getting rich with their family, corrupt judges and lawyers work together. Guyana is a civilized nation. You, the young generation, unite together, where Indian and blacks can live together as brothers and sisters. Condemn the emancipation, because you were not emancipated, and demand your birth rights as the black fellow citizen. Because you were born there, you was not emancipated. And you, Indian, condemn the word arrival, because none of you arrived. You were born there, so claim your birth rights. And for you, my black brothers and sisters, you racial few bastards, take this word from me. We are not the Indian that you do that to. Whatever you do to us, we'll multiply it 100 to 1. Whether you live in America, Canada, or England, the world are closing in on you, darkness, today. I'm calling upon you to stop your nonsense. And if you all are agitating a woman, a BBB, to go on with a case that her name was called in, I want you all to know. You all are going to talk about banks in Guyana, our money law, our money departments, such as Western Union and MoneyGram. And this fight will not be South Korea fight alone. As Anthony Snow, it will be a fight between the big horses with base of America. So do not let your political leaders and racial bastards set you to the kill. If your name was called in a crime, the man who called it did not pick it up from a box or know you personally, it was given to him on a live show. And if you're going to behave like a fool, well, guess what? We all have to fucking die. And I don't care who you got behind you. It's a message we're going to reveal here today. He was jailed wrongfully under the APNU government. Ramjetan have to give up that paper yet. He was beaten by 4 black police officers and 3 attempts on his life, which is kidnapping and attempt murder. Ramjetan, don't cross this line. I may lose him. Your family are in England. I mean, America, Canada, and Mojib Nagamutu. Your daughter is living in a beautiful house in Ohio. Do not let us meet to that direction, brother. It is not a fucking threat. And for a lot of you in the army and the police force, I want you all to know, you are not ready for what is yet to come. Don't make this politician lie to you. You need 2 acre land per family. You need at least $300,000 to build your dream house so you could take care of your wife and children. How many police in dying duty? What they probably get? Nothing. How many teachers in suffering getting nothing? But politicians are getting everything. So I call upon all of you to be united for a great Guyana with unity, love, and transparency. And let's stop the fighting amongst one another and unite. Why only you, the black race? And the Indian got problem for power. What about the Portuguese, the Chinese, and the Amerindian, and the mixed race? So I'm calling on the decent black and Indian. Unite with the Portuguese, Chinese, and the mixed race, and Amerindian, and we are in for a great Guyana that the world can respect, where we all will love and unite with your home and your children and put Guyana forward. Hell with the corrupt politician. Have a good day.